AES does not use Pizl structure, but process the entire data block in parallel during each round using substitutions and permutations. In AES, we have totally 10 rounds. In each round, it's not following any Pizl structure, but the data is actually processed in parallel. Okay, all the substitution and permutations will be done in parallel, just like DES. In AES, as the proposal is given, the block length is 128 bits, and the key length is also 128 or 192 or 256 bits. But in general, most of the times we are using 128 bits. So I am explaining this algorithm as a consideration of 128 bits. The remaining bits, for remaining keys, the algorithm is same. Now in AES, we treat or depict the block as a square of bytes. I already told our block length is 128 bits, that is nothing but 16 byte. We depict our data as a 4 into 4 matrix. Each row contains 4 bytes. Totally we have 4 rows. Like that, the depict will be done. The block is copied into a state array. Temporary memory is used by this algorithm, and that is called a state array. We place our plain text into that state array in a particular order. The order is explained in this diagram here. The ordering of bytes within a matrix is by column. What actually we are doing, if we consider this one is the plain text of 128 bits, the first 4 byte, okay, is actually first column of the matrix. The next 4 bytes is the next column of the matrix. Like that, it is storing in the state array. In similar way, we have 128 bits or 16 bytes for a key. Okay, the key is also depicted as square matrix of bytes. In similar way, we are treating our key. Now, in one key, we have totally 4 words. Each word is 4 bytes. Now, this is word 1, word 2, like that one. Each key has 4 words, and each word size is 4 bytes. Okay, now we have to expand our array of key schedule. This input key is given, is then expanded into array of key schedule words. Each word is 4 bytes, and the total key schedule is 44 words for the 128 bits. That means I have to create totally 11 keys. Totally, I need 11 keys, and that 11 key is each 11 key is actually 4 word. So I need totally 44 key schedule words. Okay, totally I need 44 key schedule words. Why I need 11 keys, I will explain in the next slide. Here, for each totally, as I told, I have totally 10 rounds and one extra key I needed at the beginning. Okay, so I need the 11 keys. The first four bytes of the expanded key, which form the word, occupy the first column in the word W matrix. This is explained here. Okay. As I told here, now see, each totally I need 11 keys. For the first round, I need one additional key here. Each round takes here 4 words of key. That means one key is needed for one round. Okay, now totally I have 10 rounds. So 40 keys are needed here and additional one key is needed at the first step of the algorithm. Okay, now in each round here, in each round there are 4 stages are there, 4 steps are there. One step is actually transformation, sorry, permutation, and the remaining 3 stages are actually substitutions. Now this is the permutation and the remaining 3 are actually substitutions. We learn one by one what are these steps actually. Now the first step is actually substitute bytes. What is the meaning of substitute bytes? It is uses S-box table to perform a byte by byte substitution of the block. What it will do? There is one table called as S-box table, also called as substitute box table. Okay. Now I will display here. This is a state. Okay, and this is first column, second column, third column, fourth column. Now I have taken a substitute box table and take the first 4 word here, next 4 word here, next 4 word here, like that I placed and do some substitution on the data. Whatever the substitution you done on the plain text is stored again in the state again here. Okay, that is done in the same state again here. Now state contain some scrambled data. Now we are going to the next step here, that is called a shift rows. Now see here, the next step is shift rows. Okay, what happens in the shift rows? Shift row is actually a simple permutation that is performed row by row here, shifting the row by row here. Each row is shifted to the different positions. First row go to the first row go to the last row go to the first, like that it will shift the rows here. That is called as shifting the rows. The next step is called as here mixed columns. Okay, what is the meaning of mixed column? A substitution that alters each byte in the columns as a function of all of the bytes in the column. Here it will take the byte by byte from the columns and do some substitution. Okay, column wise substitution. So it is called as mixed columns. The last is actually called as add round keys. Here this part is called as add round keys. Now this here, the last step of the round is actually, this is the round, this is the last step, add round keys. In add round keys, a simple bitwise XOR operation will be done between the current block which is stored in the state. Okay, here the scrambled data, so many different substitution and permutation will be done. It will create some scrambled data that is called as current block. Okay, using that current block, it will perform some XOR operation with the help of key. Okay, I have passed here 4 bytes of word here, keyword. Okay, now on that one, it will perform some XOR operation. Whatever the result you got, it is stored in the state again. And this is the ciphered text. Now both the encryption and decryption, the cipher begins with add round stage, add round key stage. You see here in the both plain cipher, encryption and decryption, add round key is the first step. Okay, and one more point, the in last step we are not having mix columns step. That is only three steps are available here in the last 10th round. If you see here, here also only three rounds. That is mixed column will be removed. As I told here, all the 9 rounds contain 4 stages, but the last round, the 10th round, contains only the 3 stages. Okay, next one here, the key which is given as an input is used only in the last step, that is called as add round key. In that stage only we are using the keys, but here we are doing some scrambling, but we are not using any key to scramble the data here. So we can treat here, we can view this cipher as a, we can see this cipher as actually alternating operations of XOR encryption, okay, of a block of block followed by scrambling of block. Okay, first you have to do here add round key, you are running at the top here, add round key, then scrambling of the block. Okay, scrambling of the block, then again you do the add round key. So this will protect and this will make a more cryptic text. Okay, in a decryption, each stage is easily reversible. In decryption mode, each stage is easily reversible. In add round stage, the inverse is achieved by XORing the same round key to the block. Okay, if you go to here, you just XOR the same key which is given in the encryption, just XOR with the same key, again it is decrypted. Okay, but the remaining three stages, apart from add round key, the remaining three stages we have to use inverse functions. Okay, we have to use inverse functions. What I am trying to say here, just like DES, the encryption is not same as decryption technique here. We have to do some alteration in the decryption, that is called as inverse the function, as well as we have to add the key in a reverse order. Okay, this is the concept we explain in the AES.